Parashat Vaera. The end of Parashat Shmot and the beginning of Parashat Vaera teach us that Paro tried to squash and crush Moshe's demands for freedom and punish the people with even harsher conditions. Moshe is dismayed, and the Jewish people distance themselves from Moshe. The Torah describes their frustration in terms, "V'lo shamuel Moshe mikotzer ruach u'miavodah kasha." They couldn't hear Moshe because of the shortness of breath and because of the burdens of work. According to the Ramban, kotzer ruach means that they were barely breathing and had no strength to listen to Moshe's vision for the future. But interpreting kotzer ruach can also be understood from a more modern lens. Viktor Frankl, Holocaust survivor, psychiatrist, founder of logotherapy, and author of Man's Search for Meaning, understood from the misery of the Holocaust that even if everything is taken from a person, even if people lose all that is precious to them, the only human freedom that cannot be taken is the freedom to choose an attitude. For Dr. Frankl, surviving meant searching for and aspiring to achieve meaning. Without meaning, life had no value. Perhaps kotzer ruach meant, in Frankl's language, a loss of meaning. The Jewish people had no hope and no purpose. At that point, the work, the avodah, was unbearable. The burdens of slavery were crushing as they lost all hope. Moshe's job as Redeemer was not only to inflict punishment on Egypt, but was also tasked to inspire meaning and provide the people with purpose. Informed by their goals and values, they'd be able to realign their attitudes, embrace new realities, and begin to hope again. As we commemorate the 75th anniversary of the liberation of Auschwitz, we should not only think about the misery and cruelty that the Nazis and their criminal collaborators inflicted upon our people, but we should also take inspiration from the survivors, who taught us to search for meaning, to embrace values, and find the strength to rebuild even after tragedy. We wish you a Shabbat Shalom.